Congratulations as being part of this celebration, and also on the astonishing impact that 1917 is having. Can you talk about, for you, why it was such an important and poignant story to bring to life with that film?
I just think it's so important to remember what them men did and what they fought for. You know, it's good for the younger generation to see as well. But also, it's not really a history lesson. It's not an educational film about the war. It's just a story about humans and what happens when you're pushed to your absolute limits. And it's as well. It's a cinematic experience. You're not just watching it. It's a film you definitely got to go out to the cinema to see.
You talk about the experience of working with a master storyteller in Sam Mendes in a completely unique production style.
Yeah, the thing I love about Sam is that every film he's done is always a completely different genre. And, just to put it simply, he's just such a good director, a master. And he's just amazing at directing, working with actors. And the thing that I love, one of the things that I love about him is his blocking. The way he blocks out a scene, it comes across so natural and not a direction. It feels lived, everything what he does, and that's a very special thing.
There's a very special chemistry between you and George in the film. Can you talk a little bit about the bond that you have and what makes him such a fantastic performer?
Oh my God. George is honestly like one of my favourite actors, seriously. And and put all that aside, he's just such a lovely bloke, probably the loveliest bloke I ever met. And the thing that I love about George's performance in 1917 is that it's so subtle, but yet he's telling 1,000 words with just his eyes. And he hasn't actually got that much dialogue in the film. But yet he tells such a beautiful story with his face and his emotions, and he gives such a physical performance. As for the chemistry, we just spent every single day with each other. 6 months rehearsals, the training, the research. We went to France and Belgium, and we just really got to know each other.
Curious, when you look back on that extraordinary production, do you have a most precious memory from set?
I've got a lot of memories. Do you know what? A lot of the memories, the stuff that really obviously stick out in my brain is like the first times I saw the sets, like all the trenches that had been dug, and all the extras in their costumes for the first time being placed in the trench. And just looking and looking down the trench with it raining and looking at everyone in their costume, that's the closest you could get to recreating the First World War. So a lot of images like that are in my head, yeah.
Looking to the future, apart from a lot of awards shows, what have you got coming up now?
To be honest, I'm just reading scripts at the minute just to see what's next. We're trying to get out, finish the award season, and which I think Oscars is like the last stop. And then, we'll see what's next after that.
And just finally, what does that awards recognition, all those nominations mean for you and the rest of the team behind this film?
It's amazing. It's still... I'm still taking it all in, to be honest with you, and it's everyone works really hard, and when you've had such an amazing time in the filmmaking, and then that aligns with the audience responding to it well, that's, you couldn't ask for more of a dream come true, really. It's the best thing, and I just can't wait to go to it all.
It's amazing to have you here tonight, and congratulations on being honoured here. Can I ask, 1917 is a film that's had an astonishing impact, not just on award season, but on audiences. What is it about the story that matters so much for you, and why were you so determined to make all the sacrifices necessary to tell it in this way?
I think, to be honest, first and foremost, it was the opportunity of working with Sam, and then these opportunities to tell a story such as this. The script, first and foremost, is the most beautiful script I've ever read. And to tell that story, and in the way that Sam and everyone wanted to make it, those opportunities are rare. So I think that, as much as anything, was the reason to give everything. And the film, in a sense, is about that. It's about sacrifice. It's about giving your all in service of something greater than yourself. And, you know, I think to truly sort of get that across, you have to embody that in the making of it, and that's hopefully that's what resonates with people. The people feel that in the film, and that's why it was so gratifying to make it in that way too. First and foremost, like with Dean, he's golden. Like he's such a wonderful actor, and he's such a good man. And we spent every day together from pretty much the last audition. You know, we went to France, we went to Belgium, and we did 6 months of rehearsals together every day, experiencing all this new stuff, this new way of working, the excitements, the ups and downs, the pressures of it. We did all of that together, so that bonded us uniquely, I think. And it was just a pleasure playing scenes with him. He's such a he's so in the moment, he's so natural as an actor. When with so many technical aspects of the film and having to have an inside outside perspective on the performance, to just trust that you could just let it go, and that when you're working with Dean that you just exist in that moment, that was the most special thing. And then in terms of working with everyone else, all the other cast, it was amazing. Like the specificity with which they all work, Andrew, Benedict, Mark, the way that they can pull out moments and in the inflection of a line is incredible. And also Claire de Burke, who is lesser known. I think it's actually her first job. She did the most electric audition. It was such a pleasure working with her. And I think she's a stunning actress. So it was such a pleasure, the whole thing. Like, it was genuinely the best.